The Tale of Two Lazy Princes. Come, children, let's listen to a story. The Tale of Two Lazy Princes. There once was a king who had two sons, but both were very spoiled. The excessive pampering by the king and queen had made them extremely stubborn and lazy. Whatever they liked, no matter how expensive, was immediately brought to them. Now that the two princes had grown up, the king wanted them to help with the affairs of the kingdom. However, both had become extremely lazy and idle, staying up all night and sleeping all day. Whenever the king tried to reason with them, saying, "You are grown up now. You must realize your responsibilities," the queen would interfere and say, "Why are you always after them? These are still my prince's days to play. When the time comes, they will take on their responsibilities." Hearing this, the king would remain silent, but he knew that a good king must be intelligent, compassionate, and brave, qualities that come from proper education and training. He worried silently that if his princes did not receive the right education and training, how would they run the kingdom? Time passed, but the king found no solution to his worry. The king's kingdom was very beautiful, with tall mountains, vast forests with dense trees, clear streams flowing everywhere, and large green fields. Due to snowfall in winter and extremely pleasant weather in summer, people came from far and wide to visit. Often, kings and their families from neighboring countries visited as royal guests, staying in the king's palace and receiving splendid hospitality. Because of this, neighboring countries were very pleased with this king and never waged war against him. They all lived together in peace. The beauty and tranquility of his kingdom were renowned worldwide. Once, during the summer, a king and queen from a far-off land came to visit with their daughter, the princess. The princess was as beautiful as a fairy. Anyone who saw her could not take their eyes off her. As per tradition, they were given a grand welcome and hosted with great respect in the royal palace. The visiting king and queen were very impressed by the sincere hospitality. A banquet was arranged for the guest king that night, and both lazy princes reluctantly attended. Upon seeing the lovely princess, both fell in love with her. After the banquet, the elder prince went to his mother and said, "Mother, I really like that princess, and you must arrange my marriage with her at any cost." While this conversation was happening, the younger prince also arrived and expressed the same desire to marry the princess. The queen was very worried and went straight to the king to inform him. Hearing this, the king too became worried, and they both thought about how they had never denied any request of their princes, but wondered what to do now. The king was very wise. The next day, he met the guest king and princess, telling them everything and admitting that his sons were very lazy and uninterested in the affairs of the kingdom. The princess, being very intelligent, told the king not to worry and that she would go for a walk in the garden the next evening and would like to meet both princes there. Hearing this, the king was relieved and informed the princes that they could test their luck the next day, as the princess would decide whom she liked. This made both princes very happy. That night, the princess thought about how to rid herself of such lazy and idle princes. She thought that outright refusal would be inappropriate because they had been such gracious hosts. Unable to come up with a solution, she eventually fell asleep. The next evening, when the princes came to meet her in the garden, the princess said, "You both are very nice. Actually, I want to marry the most educated and capable person in the world. So whoever among you proves to be more capable, I will accept his proposal." This news reached both kings, and they decided to give the princes a year to prepare thoroughly, and exactly 1 year later, they would compete, and the more capable one would marry the princess. Everyone agreed to this decision. Both princes then began to work hard. The best teachers in the kingdom were brought to the palace to help them. The princes, who were always lazy and idle, completely changed and started working day and night. The king was very pleased to see this and encouraged them greatly. After a year of tireless effort, both princes became very capable. They were no longer idle, but were actively involved in the kingdom's affairs. The day of the competition finally arrived, and the princess and her parents arrived as promised. The competition began, and many learned scholars posed difficult questions, but both princes answered them all, showing such brilliance that everyone was amazed. From morning till evening, it was impossible to decide who was more capable. Eventually, the competition ended in a draw. Everyone was puzzled about what to do next. The princess was also standing there, bewildered. She had set the condition only to rid herself of the lazy princes, but here everything had turned upside down. A deep silence fell in the court. Just then, the two princes conferred briefly, and the elder prince stepped forward, saying, "Actually, the princess did not want to marry either of us. She set the condition of capability just to get rid of us. But we are grateful to the princess because she freed us from laziness and idleness, and we have understood our responsibilities." The king was very pleased with his son's intelligence and capability. He thanked the princess and gave her many precious gifts. The princess and her parents returned to their country happily.